Welcome to the next study unit within the chapter PV system components. Here we will look at mounting systems for PV modules. An essential component in addition to the modules and the inverter is the mounting system to which the PV modules are attached. The choice of mounting systems depends first and foremost on the type of the system. For a ground-mounted PV system, a different mounting system is needed than for a system on a flat roof or even a pitched roof. In addition to the type of system, the weight of the modules, whether the modules are framed or unframed, and how high the loads from wind or snow can be, are also decisive factors. Let's first look at the mounting of ground-mounted systems. Depending on the ground, this often involves driving a steel rod into the ground or twisting a screw-shaped tube into the ground. On rocky ground, a concrete foundation can also be used. The frame is bolted to the foundations and then support profiles are attached to it. The profiles are usually made of aluminum or galvanized steel. The modules are then connected to the profiles using module clamps. Solar modules produce the highest yield when they are optimally aligned with the sun in terms of both their orientation and their tilt angle. However, the optimum angle of inclination and also the orientation change in the course of a day with the position of the sun. Therefore, there are also mounting systems in which the modules track the sun. Such solar trackers are usually used for large ground-mounted systems. Basically, a distinction can be made between single-axis and dual-axis tracking systems. With single-axis tracking systems, one axis, for example, the north-south axis, remains constant, but another, for example, the east-west axis, is tracked by an electric motor in the course of the day. In two-axis tracking systems, the modules also track the sun around a second axis. However, the construction of a two-axis tracking system is very expensive and maintenance intensive as well. However, depending on the location of the system, additional yields of up to 30% can be achieved. Next, let's look at the mounting on roofs. Here the mounting method depends largely on the shape and the material of the roof. On a flat roof, the solar modules are usually mounted on mounting racks that allow an inclination and orientation. In addition to a south orientation, an east-west orientation of the modules is also possible. In this case, half of the modules is mounted towards the east and the other half towards the west. This way, the generation of PV electricity can be distributed over the day and self-consumption can be increased. Mostly, aluminum mounting systems are used here. They are installed either with or without roof penetration. With roof penetration, the mounting system is firmly attached to the roof with screws. This form of mounting allows the PV modules to be mounted at a higher angle of inclination, as they can also withstand higher wind resistance. However, during roof penetration, the roof cladding is penetrated. The roof cladding is both part of the thermal insulation and a protection against water penetration. There is therefore a risk of leakage with this type of mounting. An alternative are mounting systems without roof penetration. Here, several elements are often screwed together so that the modules are more stable overall. Here you can see an example of a flat roof mounting system from Lorenz Montagesysteme. In addition, weights are used for weighting, for example, stones. However, depending on the statics of the roof, the use of weights to fix the mounting system is limited. In this case, the area exposed to wind can be minimized by selecting a lower tilt angle and additionally attaching backplates to the rear of the modules. In the case of a pitched roof, the orientation and the angle of inclination of the modules are usually predetermined by the roof. In most cases, PV systems are mounted as on-roof systems on an existing house roof. To fix the mounting system, so-called roof hooks are first connected to the roof substructure. Here you can see an example of a roof hook made by Lorenz Montage System. The roof tiles lying over the roof hooks are usually cut so that they do not crack under subsequent mechanical load. It is important to keep the hook at a sufficient distance from the roof tile. In case of snow load, the hook may bend and possibly damage the tile underneath. The number of roof hooks depends on the load, meaning the weight of the modules as well as the expected load from wind and snow. Horizontal rails are then mounted on the roof hooks, to which the solar modules are later attached. These rails are made of special aluminum profiles, which are usually also suitable for holding the module connection cables. The modules can then be fixed to the rails with so-called module clamps. Each module is fixed with four module clamps. So-called end clamps are used at the edge of the roofs, and middle clamps are used between two modules to connect the modules together. Sometimes vertical rails are first mounted on the roof hooks, to which the horizontal rails are later attached. This cross-rail mounting is mainly chosen when the spacing of the rafters is not optimal and the required mounting points of the PV modules can otherwise not be met. This is often the case, for example, when the modules are mounted horizontally or in landscape. In addition, the greater distance between the roof and the modules leads to a better rear ventilation of the modules and thus to lower operating temperatures. Apart from tilted roofs, trapezoidal or corrugated metal sheet roofs are a common type of roofs. These roofs are mainly used on industrial halls or other commercial buildings. There are various special mounting systems for these roofs. Short rails are often used, which are screwed directly onto two high beds each. The modules are then clamped to four short rails each. The short rail system is a very cost-effective and fast method of mounting. Another significant advantage over the use of continuous support rails is the thermal decoupling of roofing and mounting rails. Due to the divided rails, no tensions occur in the event of different thermal expansion of the materials. We now have learned about various mounting systems. Let's summarize the most important points. The type of mounting system depends on the underground. The expected snow and wind loads play a significant role in the selection of the fastening system. The roof surfaces, the load-bearing capacity of the roof must also be taken into account. I thank you for your attention.